I guess Vortex is like a good word to describe Byron. It's like a bit of a vortex, so you can get trapped, but also it's a pretty good vortex to get trapped in. Some weird like Scottish dude, and he just was in the shower and I was like, "How are you, man?" And he just said, "Oh, not very good." And he said, "Almost drowned the other day." "How come?" And he said, "Well, apparently I have diabetes." And he said, I just went for a swim, lost my legs, and two guys just rescued me." He's like, "I'm a surfer from back in the day and it's just heavy, like I can't even go for a swim anymore." He used to surf at Kira and he used to live next door to MP, and then he said MP rules. It was pretty cool, dude. Yeah, he lived in his combi, homeless. Yeah, I know a few homeless dudes, but off the top of my head, I can't really remember any of their names. Apart from this one mad fucking dude called Duncan.
I knew Duncan when I was really young. I did the Pro Juniors with him, and he was fucking doing massive chop hops and bunny hops and shit on waves. And that was the first time I saw him.
He's just a legend. He's super funny, and he's just a mysterious guy. He's just wandering. He's definitely not lost in life. He's just making life his own adventure, and it's just epic.
Yeah, you're just like looking after yourself. If your car's dirty, it's your own fucking fault. No one else's. Just like living the biggest benefit.
No rant, eh?
No, $150 a week or fucking however much. I thought someone would have tried to at least break into my car, like not being able to lock it. Everyone's real friendly. Should just start leaving one door open so everyone thinks I'm back in five. People just assume you don't have a job or you can't get a house because you're too sketchy. But it's not the case. We do it for the lifestyle. My brother Angus, who also lives in his car, we just do the same thing together, just cruising our car. He's pretty tall and hairy.
We need to write a book, Code of Conduct.
Oh, yeah. Code of Conduct.
How to rot the system.
Yeah, loopholes.
Oh, dude, I'm just having a bit out.
Everyone has their own meaning and their own choices and plans. So I don't know what my meaning is. I guess my meaning is I like just going surfing and hanging out.
Alright, so there. Tell us a little bit about Byron.
Well, when I first arrived here, I was a different person, and I came here seeking some spiritual guidance. I'm not really too into the surf culture of Byron. I used to come here when I was growing up. My parents used to bring me here on holidays. I mean, I wouldn't be anywhere else in the world. I love Byron. Like, it's a part of me. It's a big part of me.
Talk about.
I ended up hooking up with this girl in 2010. She was my best friend, she was my partner and my lover, and we had a good relationship. And one day Natasha ran away and stole this guy's medication, and a week and a half later my friend's mum found her and she'd overdose. Yeah, that was a really big big hit to me. Like, it was like a big tragedy to me. It really like crushed me. And then I spent about close to 2 years living in the bush by myself. It was a big transformation for me. Like, it was a big part of letting go of the past and being in the now, and Byron really sort of pushed me into being in the here and now, not living in the past, not living in yesterday and what happened yesterday, what happened the day before that. It's right now, right here, right now. And Byron really like did that for me, and it's been like an amazing transformation. I wouldn't change it for anything. It's changed me forever, and I'm forever changed, but for the good. Yeah.
Part of the reason a lot of people come here, because it's not, doesn't have that whole city vibe and, you know, that whole chaotic hustle and bustle. It's just got such a cruisy lifestyle that I guess a lot of people do get stereotyped as hippies.
Just the whole vibe. You get the full, not only the hippie vibe when you get into town, but it's a lot more laid back. There's a lot of people riding around in their bikes and walking in the middle of the road. And did I just contradict myself? Heaps.
There's heaps of hippies around, but there's also heaps of normality and, like, people that are, like, full business and stuff, definitely. My parents were pretty straight and just worked and never really surfed or anything, like, I don't know. But it's a pretty healthy place to live. Everyone kind of get psyched on their health.
Byron turns from like one place to a completely different town when the as soon as the sun goes down. It's fun, you see some weird shit, people busking on the streets, people begging for money. There's a lot of Byron people that wake up here every morning, no memory. They've been raped, they've had things stolen, they've shat themselves. There are two sides to Byron. There's the magical side and then there's the nightmare. Which do you want to experience? Flip a coin.
The drug culture? I don't know, there's a party scene and everyone smokes a fair bit, but I don't know if it'd be any worse than anywhere else. I wouldn't say it's too... it's abused too much. Maybe it is.
Yeah.
Now most of us have smoked. I don't know many surfy dudes that haven't smoked pot. The police took my bong the other night, bastards. And me mix.
Won't they come down here at 3:30 in the morning with his music up full bore, waking everybody up? And the Japanese guy came over and grabbed him by the hair through his window and said, shut the fuck up, I'm a third damn martial artist and I'll kill you if you don't fucking turn your music off. And Wayne, I went and grabbed the knob.
We'll be right back.
insane way in the hurricane. I've been told is his name. What the go with this guy is, he's like 1% truth, 99% fabricated live something that's going on.
We slept there, you know, that big double fold at me. Everyone's going, who's there? And I said, could be Slater, could be Fanny, could be anyone. Why don't I sleep anyone? We said, he's out. And play you a song off it and blow your mind.
About 20 grand worth of stereo. I don't know the table to throw it. I ain't telling you about that.
Here we go.
It's in the back. I think it's in the back.
As a snow flies.
They sing it, God.
On a cold and gray Chicago.
He talks his life up to be some extraordinary life. It's kind of funny, but it's kind of heavy at the same time, because you don't know like what his actual problem is, if he's actually having a good a time is what he makes out, is what everyone kind of laughs about. Yeah.
When I was 7 years old, I got the opportunity to meet Nelson Mandela. I'm now a martial artist now. Won 4 awards recently. You know, like back in the day, I remember like everyone running down the beach just naked, and the thing you did, I was always covered up. Now I'm like, you put your clothes on there. Well, I'm just saying, there was just this stream, and everyone used to just swim in it. And the other day, actually, Tom Curran, who played the other night, was world champion 3 times, and Bowlesy beat him 3 times. So I ran in and punched Curran in the arm 3 times. He said, what the fuck's that for one? I said, because Bowlesy's out there. Bowlesy's out the front going, he danced like this. The big unit. It's true. It's true, mate.
True! Ripping! Get out there, Ty.
Get out
there, yeah, Roz. Little interview with the boys.
You know, we're not. I don't think any of us plan on being the best surfers in the world or anything like that, but. Our plan is just to have a heap of fun, travel as much as we can, experience different culture and lifestyles, just have a heap of fun.
Yeah.
why not be here? You know, I could buy into the place and live here forever, but I'd get bored with this. And I'd go out bush like I did last night, I just left. And then I'll come back in when I've rejuvenated to handle the jazz and the jazzer of Byron. In time I find the fly inside this cloud of rats with brains. It's like he's a soul. He's a
tats or something. Sick tats.
I'm a professional surfer.